Sa video natin ngayon, we will discuss in detail the moment distribution method, which is developed by Hardy Cross and is known as the stiffness method. Now, sa method na to, we would need to memorize a few things. First, we set our sign convention for the end moments as counterclockwise moment is negative for the reactive moment. Bale, ito, this is counterclockwise, negative yung sign convention natin dyan. And then, positive naman if clockwise yung end moment. So, this is, ito yung first natin na dapat ma-remember. And then next, the end moments for all of the loadings shown are on the negative effect since all the loads are downward. So, P is acting downward, ito naman, and then all of our distributed loads are acting downward. Now, by the way, this is W pala. Yan. And then, you have to remember that if the loads are acting upward, the direction of the end moments would be the opposite. So, for example, ito yung fixed end natin, fixed ended beam. And then, the load is upward. Ibig sabihin yan, this fixed end would have a clockwise reaction. And then, ito naman, this would have a counterclockwise reaction. Yan, if upward yung load. But usually naman, we are dealing with downward loads lang. And so, we need to memorize the following end moments. So, kung meron kang concentrated load sa gitna, we have PL over 8, and then the same lang sa other side since this is symmetrical. And then, if we have a load that is placed anywhere along the span, yan, we have PAB squared over L squared, and PBA squared over L squared. However, in my undergrad years, since mas mahirap ang item sa structural theory kesa sa board exam, and merong irregular loadings palagi, yung ginawa ko is itong formula na to lang yung minemorize ko. And then, kinumbine ko na lang with the concept of integral calculus. And also, this formula pala. So, bale, this formula and also this one. Yan lang yung mga pinaka-importante talaga. Now, sir, paano yan siya ma-apply? How can we apply the concept of integral calculus? We can use this one. And let's say lang na ito yung gusto mo. And then, let's try out any value. Tatry natin, W equals 8 kilonewton per meter. And then, L is equal to, let's say, 9 meters. So, using this formula, yung left-hand moment, iko-compute natin, we have 8 times 9 squared divided by 30. Which will give us 8 times 9 squared divided by 30. This is 21.6. And then, kilonewton meter. This is negative din pala. Yan, kasi counterclockwise yung reaction. Now, if you are to use integration, wag mo na lang i-mind yung sign. Kasi absolute value yung gagamitin ko. We can choose a strip. And parang differential area. This one. So, sabihin natin, this is dx and this is y. Now, treat this as a concentrated load. And then, we're gonna add all of the concentrated loads along this triangle. Parang ganyan yung gagawin natin. Now, para ma-add natin yan, we need to apply definite integrals. So, we can label this distance as, tignan natin dito. Diba, A is measured from the left patungo sa concentrated load. So, this would be A. And then, ito naman, this is B. And then, the length is 9 meters. And then, let's try to treat this one, the distance from the left patungo sa strip natin, treat ko siya as, di ba, ito yung magsisilbing A. So, what if yan na lang din ang, yung origin ng X ko? This is a variable distance kasi yung strip natin pwede siya nandyan. So, this would be the X value. Parang ganyan. And then, i-add na lang natin lahat. So, if this is x, this distance would be 9 minus x. Yan yung magiging b natin. So, 9 minus x yan. And then, we can define y in terms of x. You can just use ratio and proportion para dito. So, the height of the triangle is, diba, 8 kilonewton per meter. Base is 9. So, 8 is to 9. Height is to the base, equals height y is to a base of 9. Is to a base of x. Yan, itong triangle na to. Y yung height and then x yung base. So, divided by x. But essentially, yung concentrated load natin is y dx. Diba? Kasi if this is a differential area, then y times dx would be a concentrated load. Parang yung distributed load lang natin. But I would like to think of it na ito lang, and then yung dx naman by default nasa dulo yan ng calculator. But galing yan sa y times dx. Yan yung value ng concentrated load. So now we can define y equal to x. Multiply mo lang sa kabilang side. We have 8 over 9x. So now we can apply definite integrals. So our limit would be from the starting point of the loading to the ending point. Kasi diba ito yung origin ng x natin. So this would be from 0 to 9. Kasi 9 yung length. And then we can apply this formula. Ito. PAB squared over L squared for the left end moment. Now our P is this one. 8 over 9 multiplied by x. But meron pa yung dx essentially. But instead of putting it here, dito na lang. And then, what is A? A is equal to x according to our labels. And then B naman is 9 minus x. So times 9 minus x and then squared. Divided by L squared, so 9. 9 squared. So input natin sa calculator, and then dapat yung sagot niya is the same sa 21.6 na nakuha natin applying the general formula. So from 0 to 9, and then we have 8 over 9x times x, then 9 minus x, square natin, divided by 9 squared. So this is 21.6, the same lang. Kilonewton meter. And then, yung sign niya talaga is negative. Kasi counterclockwise siya. So, ganyan lang yung approach. If nakalimutan mo yung formula, it's best to memorize this one. So, madali lang naman kasi PAB squared over L squared. Kung saang side ka, hindi siya masi-square. Like, for example, if dito ka sa side A, yan, itong A, hindi yan siya masi-square. So, ito lang. And then, meron din tayong cases na merong support settlement. Now, kung merong support settlement, ibig sabihin, nag-move yung support, ito yung formula natin. 6EI times delta, where delta is the difference in elevation from this point to this point. And then, E is the modulus of elasticity of the material. And then, I is the moment of inertia. Then, L is the length of the span. Now, you have to take note that if sinking on the left side occurs, then positive yung sign nito. Yung dalawa. Now, if yung sinking naman occurs on the right side, then negative yung dalawa. Always yan, the same yung signs nila. Now, meron din naman tayong example mamaya using this one para mas ma-internalize nyo. Now, discuss naman natin itong distribution factors, which we will call DF. This is a unitless quantity for which the formula is k divided by the summation of k. Now, what is k? K is the member stiffness, which is defined by the formula 4EI over L. Now, para mas maintindihan nyo talaga, we can derive the following formulas. But first, we will discuss kung ano yung carryover moments. So, we have carryover moments. Ayan. Now, copy ko na lang yung definition sa matalino. Ito. Carryover moment is defined as the moment induced at the fixed end of a beam by the action of the moment applied at the other end. Now, let us try to consider this figure. Ayan. Consider the prop beam shown dito. Now, we can compute the deviation from B with respect to the tangent at A. Now, the tangent at A is just going to be a straight line. Diba? Kasi fixed yan, walang rotation na mangyayari dyan. Now, computing this one, we would have ito muna, yung area ng triangle na yan. this would be 1 half times base, which is L, multiplied by MA. And then yung ano niya, centroid is located dito. So this distance would be, di ba, patungo yan sa matabang side ng triangle, ito naman sa narrowing portion. So this would be 2/3 of L. So deviation from B kasi with respect to A, sa B tayo mag-moment. So itong moment arm na to yung gagamitin natin. So times 2/3 of L. And then ito naman, this triangle naman, yung centroid niya is andito. And then this is 1/3 of L. Kasi patungo tayo sa matabang side ng triangle. So 1/3 of L, and then our area is 1/2 times base na L. And then yung height natin is MB. And then multiply natin by the moment arm, 1/3 of L. Yan. Now since walang deviation na mangyayari, since meron kang support dito, then this would be equal to 0. Ayan. So notice na magka-cancel yung 2, so this would become 1. And then L times L, di ba, L squared. Dito rin, L times L is L squared. So magka-cancel yan lahat. Ayan. So matitira na lang would be MA times 1/3 plus 1/2 times MB times 1/3. Now, common yung 1/3, so magka-cancel din yan. And so we would have MA is equal to negative 1/2 of MB. And so this would mean that the moment applied at the roller end carries over to the fixed end a moment that is half the amount and of opposite sign. So this is what we call the carryover moment. Now dito naman tayo sa member stiffness, or tinatawag din to na beam stiffness. So the member stiffness is the moment required to produce a unit rotation at the simply supported end of a beam, the other being rigidly fixed. So from the same beam, ito lang din, kukonsider natin yan, we can compute the slope from A to B. So equal yan sa lahat ng area dyan. By the way, meron tong EI, and then we can calculate this area. So yung areas natin is makukuha lang natin dito, but just remove the moment arms. So we would have 1/2 times L times MA, and then plus 1/2 times L multiplied by MB. However, we know the value of MA, which is negative 1/2 MB. So substitute natin yan dito. So this would become 1/2 L times negative 1/2 of MB, and then plus 1/2 L multiplied by MB. So this would be EI slope from A to B. Now let's just treat this as theta. So EI theta equals 1/2 times negative 1/2, we have negative 1/4, times L times MB. Then plus 1/2 times L times MB. So notice, common yung variables natin, so pwede natin i-add yung coefficients. Now 1/2 minus 1/4, that would be positive 1/4. Yan. So EI theta is equal to 1/4 L multiplied by MB. So we would have here MB is equal to 4 EI theta, then divided by L. Now if theta is 1 radian, MB would be the beam stiffness. Beam stiffness. Now balikan natin yung definition niya. Diba, the beam stiffness is the moment required to produce unit rotation. So ito yung unit rotation, 1 radian. So kaya yung MB is equal to the beam stiffness, and then we have, label natin siya as absolute value ng K. This would be 4 EI, then substitute 1 dyan, then divided by L. So ito yung actual beam stiffness talaga. Now, gagamitin mo lang to if E differs from material to material. Now, usually naman, the same material lang yung beams natin. Pangit naman kapag aluminum yung isa and then steel yung isa, tapos pinag-connect mo yung members. So, we can just use the relative value of K. So, the relative K or relative beam stiffness is equal to I over L na lang. Yan, if constant yung E. So, we can use this one. Relative K na lang yung label natin. So, ito na lang din para mas madali siyang i-type mamaya. Now, we also have a modified K. Ayan. Now, this would apply for hinge and ruler ends. So, meron din tayong example dito mamaya. So, for hinge and ruler ends, multiply K by 3 over 4. Ayan. So, explain ko na lang mamaya kung ano yung process dito when using the modified K. So, yung need din natin talaga would be this formula and then the modified K. Dapat alam mo na 3/4 yung multiplier niya. And then, yung carryover moments. Ito. Anyway, meron tayong process na ifa-follow mamaya. Now, balikan natin yung distribution factor. At a joint, the distribution factor of a member is the ratio of the bending stiffness of the member to the sum of the bending stiffness of all the members connected to the joint. Now, let's try solving this one. We have this beam ABC and then varying yung I niya. So, this is 1I while this is 1.5I. Ayan. Now, we have to explore this one first. For fixed supports, the distribution factor is equal to 0. Kasi walang rotation na mangyayari dyan. And then for exterior hinged or roller supports, the distribution factor naman is equal to 1. So ito yung dapat mong tandaan. So therefore, sa item na to, we could solve the distribution factors. But first, kunin muna natin yung member stiffness nila. Ito yung first natin kukunin. But let's just use the relative na lang. Relative member stiffness. So, I over L. Lagay ko na lang, relative K. So, this is only I over L. Ayan. So, for span AB, the same lang yan. Meron kang KAB para sa joint na to, joint A, from A to B ka. Now, dito sa joint B, notice that we have two adjacent spans. This span is adjacent to B and also this one. So, meron kang dalawang stiffness. So, you would have from B to A, tawag natin dyan is KBA. And then from B to C, we have KBC. And then dito naman sa roller support sa pinaka-right, this would be KCB. From joint C going to B. Yan lang yung adjacent span niya. Now, KAB and KBA, equal lang yan sila. And KCB and KBC, equal lang din. Na ibang color lang. Ito, so equal lang yan sila. And then, diba, DF is K divided by the summation of K. However, since nasa pinakadulo yan na hinge, and then this is also nasa pinakadulo rin, therefore, DF at A would be equal to 1 para dito. So, yung label natin dyan is DF sub AB. DF AB. Ayan. Equal to 1. Now, how about for DF BA? Ito kasi yung isusulat natin dito. Ipapakita ko na lang ha, how it would look like sa table natin. So, parang ito yan. Construct ka ng table. And then, andito lahat ng DF mo. Distribution factors. So, since sa joint B, we have two adjacent members. So, dalawa rin. Dalawa yung DF na makukompute. And then, dito sa C, isa lang. So, DF AB is equal to 1. Lagyan mo ng 1 dyan. And then, sa B naman, we have two values. We have DFBA. We also have DFBC. Ayan. Now, DFBA would be the value of K divided by the summation of K para sa joint na yan. So, parang, ano yan, KBA, BA kasi, then divided by KBA plus KBC. Ayan. And then, for DFBC naman, this would be KBC na, kasi nasa BC na tayo, then still divided by KBA plus KBC. Summation of K at a certain joint. Yan yung ibig sabihin nito. And then, yung DFCB naman, DFCB is equal to 1 lang din. Since this is a roller support na nasa pinakadulo. So, if you want to compute DFBA and DFBC, pwede rin. Lagyan na lang natin. So, we also have 1 here. Then, DFBA is KBA over KBA plus KBC. Now, what is KBA? Ito lang yung gagamitin natin. I over L. So, we have, this is actually 1I, or lagyan na lang natin ng I. So, KBA is 1, parang I over L lang. So, L is 5. Diba? Kasi 5 yung span niya. And then, divide ko siya by the summation of K. So, for this span, I over 5 lang din. And then, plus, the adjacent span, the other one, this is 1.5i, then divided by the length, which is 6. So, divided by 6. Now, yung lahat ng i, magka-cancel lang yan. So, gagawin mo is, yung i, treat mo na lang as 1. So, we have 1 over 5, then divided by 1 over 5, plus 1.5 divided by 6. So, magiging 4 divided by 9. 4 over 9 yung DFBA. And then, for ano naman? For DFBC, move na lang natin. For DFBC, copy mo lang to. And then, just replace I over 5. Kasi magiging sa BC, 1.5 I over 6 na. Move ko na lang to. Yan, we have DFBC. So, since nasa BC na tayo, this would be 1.5i din. Bale, tanggalin na lang natin to. And then, we have 1.5i divided by 6. So, ito na lang yung palitan mo. Change this one to 1.5 divided by 6. So, this is 5 over 9. Ayan. Now, to check if tama yung DF mo, yung values ng DF, add mo yung dalawang DF sa same joint, dapat mag-equal siya to 1. So, DFBA plus DFBC must be equal to 1. Now, medyo obvious naman kasi 4 over 9 plus 5 over 9, it would just equal 1. So, tama na yung DF natin. DF values. So, lagyan mo dito ng 4 over 9. Then, this one naman is 5 divided by 9. Yan na yung values ng DF mo. So, again, kapag fixed yung support, lagyan na lang din natin ng notes dito. DF would be equal to 0. Ayan. Kasi walang rotation dyan. 0 rotation. And then for hinge or roller supports, exterior, ibig sabihin ng exterior, dapat nasa pinakadulo sila, DF is equal to 1. Which is the same lang dito sa ginawa natin. So, let's move on sa process naman. Ano yung process na dapat gawin to apply this method? Now, let's consider this beam, continuous beam. Now, first natin gagawin is to get the member stiffness para ma-solve natin yung distribution factors. So, sa joint A, we only have one adjacent member. And then sa joint B, we have two adjacent members since merong BA saka BC. So, dalawang DF. And then sa C naman, we only have one. Ayan. So, ano yung magiging DF ng A? Yung magiging DF ng A is 0. And then, yung sa B naman, you would have to solve it. So, the same lang kanina. KBA over KBA plus KBC, then DFBC would be KBC over KBA plus KBC. Now, for the sake of discussion lang, wag muna natin sulatan ng values. Bala, ito magiging 1, saka ito 0, since fixed, and then exterior roller. Pero, yung isusulat ko lang is DFAB. Yan. And then, this is DFBA. Then, DFBC. Then, ito naman is DFCB. Ayan. Now, next mong gagawin, ito yung nasa first row mo talaga. Then, for the second row, you would have the fixed end moments. So, this would be FEMAB. While dito naman, dalawang FEM. So, you would have FEMBA saka FEMBC. Then, sa point C, we have FEMCB. Now, ano yung FEM? Yung FEM, makuha mo dito. Yan, yung fixed end moments. Yan yung FEM. So, if this is point A and this is point B, then this would be FEMAB. And then, ito naman, this is FEMBA. So, ito lang yung considerations mo dyan sa FEM. Now, after writing the fixed end moments, then you would have to construct a row for the unbalanced moments. So, yung unbalanced moments, they would be the sum of moments at a point multiplied by the distribution factor. But again ha, dito, we are trying to balance the moments sa lahat ng joints. And then try to remember earlier that for the carryover moments, we have negative 1/2. So yung gagawin natin dito, we have to add the moments at the same point and multiply it by the negative of the distribution factor. So again, we would have a row for the unbalanced moments and also and another row for the carryover moments. So, ano na lang, negative DF na lang, lagyan na lang natin. So, ito yung process dyan. Zoom out natin ha, para makita nyo to. Move ko na lang. Ayan. So, gawa tayo ng first row for the unbalanced moments. So, orange yung underline natin. Ayan. So, yung gagawin natin, to solve the unbalanced moments para sa row na to, then you would have to multiply FEMAB by the negative of the distribution factor. So, mangyayari dyan is FEMAB times the negative of the distribution factor. Yan. Now, paano naman kapag meron kang dalawang adjacent members? Kapag meron kang dalawang adjacent members, hindi mo siya i-multiply agad. Hindi mo siya pwedeng i-multiply agad by the negative of the distribution factor. What you have to do is, since meron kang dalawang connected members, then i-add mo pa dapat, then you would have to add the two of them. So, bale, this is BA saka BC, so lagyan ko na lang. We have a value for FEM ABC. Now, this would be FEM BA plus FEM BC. Now, itong sum ng dalawa, yan yung imumultiply mo by the negative of the distribution factor. So, mangyayari dito is we would have FEM ABC times negative DFBA. Yan. DFBA. Na-move ko na lang to. And then, for the other side naman, this would be still FEMABC, yung sum ng dalawa, multiplied by the negative of the distribution factor. So, dito na tayo sa BC. Negative DFBC. Ayan. And then, sa pinakadulo naman, this would be FEMCB multiplied by negative DFCB. Ayan. So, ito lang yung process talaga natin. Now, meron tayong unbalanced moments. The next nyan we have to construct a row for the carryover moments, alternating itong dalawa. So unbalanced moments, then carryover moments, then unbalanced moments ulit, until mabalance natin siya. So purple na lang din yung gagamitin ko. So this would be the carryover moment. So yung gagawin mo dito sa carryover moments, magpa-partner lang sila. Bale, gagawa ka ng parang cross. So ito, carryover mo yan dito. Then this one, carryover mo dito naman. Now since nag-partner na yung dalawa, ito naman, magpa-partner din sila. So carryover this one right here, and then carryover mo to sa kabila. And then if you will carry over, you would have to divide by 2. So bale, yung carry over moment dito would be this value divided by 2. So divided by 2. Yan yung carry over moment. And then ito naman, this would be this value divided by 2. And then ito rin. Copy mo lang to, then divide by 2. And then ito rin. Copy mo to, then divide by 2. Anyway, parang mahirap pa siyang tingnan since we are dealing with letters lang. Mamaya, pag meron na tayong values, magiging madali na lang siya. So, divide mo by 2. Ayan. So, lagyan na lang natin ng process dito. Divide by 2. Then, divide by 2 ulit. Ayan. Now, this would be our first cycle. Parang first cycle natin to. Then for the second one, yan, construct ka ulit ng row para sa unbalanced moments and then another row for the carryover moments. So meron kang unbalanced moments. So the same lang yung gagawin mo. Kung ano yung ginawa mo dito, yan, the same process lang sa pangalawang cycle mo. But instead of FEM, yung carryover moment na yung gagamitin mo. So, bale, this one times the negative of DF, yan yung ilalagay mo dito, then add mo yung dalawa, itong dalawa, parang meron kang new FEM ABC. So, yan, parang FEM ABC. But this would be the carryover moment 1 ng AB plus the carryover moment 1 of BC. Yan, so the same lang, parang ito lang din. Then once makuha mo na yung unbalanced moments, gawa ka ulit ng row para sa carryover moments. So COM dito. Now the more cycles you can do, the more it will approach sa exact value talaga. But meron kasing times na masyadong mahaba na yung process mo or natatagalan ka na, but hindi pa rin siya nag-approach ng zero. So you can stop at maybe 4 cycles or 5 cycles. Since na-approximate naman niya accurately naman. Pero pag gusto mo talaga ng exact value, then you can use Microsoft Excel para mag-add ka ng different cycles. Mahirap kasi siya if by hand. So yan yung gagawin natin. So itatry natin mamaya. Let's try to first solve by hand and then let's try using Excel. So how would you know na ititigil mo na yung cycle? Ito yung gagawin mo. Stop the cycle until the unbalanced moments would be equal to or approximately equal to 0. Yan. Kasi kapag yung unbalanced moments natin mag-approach na to 0 or magiging 0 na, then wala na tayong carryover moments. So wala nang mangyayari sa next cycles mo. So ito lang yung kailangan natin i-consider. So ito yan. And then again, to simplify our calculations, we can multiply 3 over 4 to the stiffness index or K to get the modified value of K kung merong exterior hinge or roller support. So for this one, you can multiply parang yung KAB mo, pwede mong i-multiply by 3 over 4. Bali, ito yung mangyayari sa ano tawag dito? Sa modified method natin. Notice na meron tayong hinge sa pinakadulo and roller din sa pinakadulo. So, itong dalawa, exterior hinge, ito naman exterior roller. So, yung gagawin natin is, sulat natin yung DF nila. So, dito sa B, merong dalawang adjacent spans. Yan, so dalawa rin yung DF natin. Then, dito naman, we have to adjacent span CB and CD. Then dito, isa lang. So this would be 1. Kasi hinge yan sa pinakadulo, ito rin. Diba, DF is equal to 1 for exterior hinge or roller. Now, diba, meron tayong value sa KAB, then dito naman meron tayong KBA, KBC, then KCB, saka KCD. And we also have KDC. So gagawin natin, yung KAB natin saka KBA, diba, equal lang sila. Multiply this by 3 over 4. Yan. Saka ito rin, yung KCD saka KDC, multiply mo by 3 over 4. So once na multiply mo na by 3 over 4 yung dalawa, then it will affect DFBA saka DFBC and DFCB and DFCD. So that you can apply the modified method. Now ito yung mangyayari sa modified method. Diba, isusulat natin dito lahat ng fixed end moments. So FEM AB, then ito naman FEM BA, FEM BC, then FEM CB, saka FEM CD, then FEM DC. Ayan. Now, yung gagawin natin sa modified method for the unbalanced moments, the same lang, multiply this by the negative of the distribution factor. So, meron ka ng value dyan. Di ko na lang isusulat ha. Anyway, sa example natin, mas ma-internalize nyo to. Yan. So, this would be FEM AB times negative 1. Yan yung ilalagay natin dyan. Now, notice na dito sa point A saka point D, alam natin na 0 yung moments dyan. Kasi diba, nasa left end ito, then ito naman sa right end. Diba, dapat 0 yung moments dyan. So again, diba, we have DF, then FEM, then unbalanced moment, then carryover moment. So gagawin mo, if you will apply the modified method, then dito pa lang sa unbalanced moment, you will stop the cycle. Stop the cycle here. Yan, for the exterior hinge and exterior roller. So diba dito, we have FEMDC times negative 1. Notice na, if you will add all of them, then it would already become 0. And then since alam natin na 0 yung dalawang ends natin, end A saka end D, yung moments dyan are 0, since nasa left end saka right end sila, then automatic na yan. So let's say lang, our value for FEM AB is, sabihin natin, negative 60. And then our value for FEM DC is positive 64. Diba, for the unbalanced moment, negative 60 times negative of DF, or negative 1, this would be positive 60. Then 64 times negative 1, magiging negative 64. Ayan. Notice that if we will add the two moments, magzi-zero na sila. So that's why we have to stop the cycle right here. Bale, hindi na natin sila i-carry over. So gagawin mo, sa next carryover moment, gawin mo na tong 0, saka ito rin. Kasi negative 60 plus 60, pag i-add mo yung from FEM na row up to the bottom, magsi-zero na sila. So you can stop the cycle. But you can only apply this one if nag-multiply ka ng 3 over 4. Yan, yung 3 over 4, i-multiply natin sa KAB, saka KDC. So bale, sa next na cycle, ito na yung mangyayari. Copy ko to. Now, since 0 na yan, lahat ng values mo dito would be 0 na. So, 0 saka 0. Therefore, yung carryover moments mo dito would also become 0 lang din. Bale, 0 saka ito rin. Carryover. 0 na yan lahat para sa remaining na yung mga carryover moments mo sa remaining cycles. So again, meron din tayong example para dyan. Now for this example naman, hindi ko na ituturo yung process, yung ano na lang, pag-pair ng carryover moments. So, pair mo yung A saka B sa carryover moments, and then ito rin, B saka C, bale. Ito, carryover mo yan dyan. And then carry over mo yung moment dito sa point na to, and then ito naman. And then for the last one, ito yung pag-pair niya. So para yan sa carry over moments, ito yung gagawin mo. Now what if we have this configuration? Ano yung approach natin? You have to note here that kung meron kang free end, we will not have a distribution factor. However, the moment at CD can be directly computed. Now, gagawin mo dyan is treat this as an exterior ruler. And then, yung moment na makukos nito, transmit mo lang dyan. So, bale, diba, this is an overhang. Yan. So, yung new configuration mo is ito lang dapat. Bale, tanggalin mo to. Tanggalin mo yung overhang. And then just apply the moment. So, di ba, yung 10 kilonewtons, magkukos siya ng moment dito sa C, which is clockwise. Or pwede rin na isolve mo na lang agad yung magiging fixed end moment mo dito. You can treat this as a cantilever beam, yung overhang, and then you can compute the moment. So, this would be, for example, our force is 10, distance is 2, so, di ba, meron kang moment dito na 10 kilonewtons multiplied by 2 meters. Ayan. But yung FEM mo, bale, let's say, you will compute FEM CB. Ayan. This would be, ano na, negative. Counterclockwise na kasi. Parang, ito yung moment na mai-induce ng load na to, but the reaction here, kapag ginawa mo siyang fixed end, magiging, ano na siya. Since clockwise yung moment, this would be counterclockwise. 10 times 2. So, negative 20. Yung FEMCB. Now, to better understand this, i-model natin siya sa app natin. Diba, ito yung span BC natin. So, if gagawin natin siyang fully restrained, parang ganito yung mangyayari. We have an external moment of 20. Diba, parang ito yung applied moment natin. Clockwise. Due to this force. Now, kapag meron kang clockwise moment dyan, yung mangyayari is, wala nang reaction to. Yung fixed support mismo, yan yung magre-react. So, this is clockwise. Ibig sabihin, yung fixed end moment natin must be counterclockwise. So, this is FEM. This is point C, point D. So, this is FEM DC. And then, our FEM CD naman, FEM CD would be equal to 0. Yan. Ito yung concept kapag meron kang moment load na applied sa pinakadulo. Anyway, papakita natin yan. So, let's say we have a 9 meter span and then meron kang moment load dito. Clockwise. So, let's say 4. Diba, meron kang reaction dito na clockwise, then dito naman is counterclockwise. So, diba, the same lang yan dito. This one. So, kapag meron kang clockwise moment applied at any point sa span, then yung reaction niya dito is clockwise, dito naman, counterclockwise. So, clockwise, counterclockwise. However, if yung load natin ilalagay natin sa fixed end, notice na wala nang reaction dito. So, magre-react na lang is this fixed end. So, this is counterclockwise to oppose the clockwise rotation. So, kaya yung FEM mo dito, yan, kapag meron kang tinransmit na moment dyan, your FEM would be counterclockwise. Kasi clockwise yan. Counteract mo siya. So, again na, yung FEM mo would be opposite of the moment caused by the load sa overhang mo. Ayan. So, yung FEM mo is not 10 times 2, positive 20. Dapat, negative 20.